No matter how easy it might be to install Surfshark, first-time users may run into confusing and unintuitive points, and that's okay. That's why I'm here. I will show you how to install Surfshark VPN and talk about all key settings you might need. Windows tutorials comes first, and to start, we have to download Surfshark app first. To do that, just log into your Surfshark account and choose a version you need, this time for Windows. And if you don't have an account yet, you can get a subscription and sign up on the main website page. Once you have downloaded the installation file, execute it and follow the instructions to install Surfshark. The process itself would take just a couple of minutes. After the Surfshark app is installed, all that is really left to do is to turn it on. And before I'll get into settings inside the app, let me show you how to install Surfshark for Mac. It's actually easier to do. Just go to the App Store and download the app from there. It will install Surfshark automatically and you will be able to launch it easily. That said, there's actually another Mac app available through the Surfshark website page. But this app requires a different installation process, and needless to say, unless you want these updates, I won't recommend getting this app. In a pleasant turn of events, Surfshark just updated and it now offers a Linux GUI app, as opposed to the console version it had previously. You can get this version from the Surfshark website, just like the Windows one. Okay, at this point, you should have a working app, and double-clicking it will bring you to the main page. Time to learn how to use Surfshark VPN effectively. The main screen has all you need to start working: list of servers, some choice of specialized servers if you need them, and a quick connect button for the cases when a specific country is not necessary. This list of servers will show a lot of countries you can connect to, while quick connect always connects to the location that is physically the closest to you. Specialized servers also have a nuance. Static IP is more important if you plan to use it with a website that is sensitive to frequent IP change, like Netflix. Multi-hop, on the other hand, will just chain two servers together for extra security, but it will reduce your speeds. Let me connect to a server for a moment to show you how it works. One click and it's actually done. If you want to check if your VPN actually works, head to the website like this one and check your current IP and location. It should reflect the server you're connected to. Now, let's get a bit deeper. If you scroll to the upper left corner, you will notice there are multiple menus you can access. Now, Alert, Antivirus, and Search are part of the Surfshark One package, and they come at an extra price, so I won't touch any of them. But the Settings menu is where you should click. Head to the VPN settings and from there and check settings there. I personally recommend to keep CleanWeb and KillSwitch always on. CleanWeb will block ads and invasive links with malicious files, while KillSwitch will terminate your connection if VPN fails, preventing data leaks. I think that both are essential at keeping you secure and preserving privacy. AutoConnect can also be neat, but it's not necessary in most cases, unless you need your VPN to be always on. A little below, you can choose your protocol. I recommend using WireGuard for the best speed. One could argue that OpenVPN or IKEv2 are more time-proven and reliable protocols, but if you are looking for the best performance, WireGuard is your friend. Going further, you can configure Bypasser. I only recommend doing it if you have an app that must or must not be routed through VPN. For example, if you often torrent, you might need to route only your torrenting app through Surfshark. These are the main security elements you can configure, and if you want to go into more detailed features, it's better to connect to customer support. They have a 24/7 live chat and they will help you anytime. Next, I want to mention a couple of things Surfshark could do for you. For instance, one account can supply your whole family with a VPN connection. After all, Surfshark doesn't have a limit on simultaneous connections to one account, which is actually very nice, especially if you are interested in streaming. I've tested Surfshark and it managed to access various geo-blocked content like Netflix libraries. Considering all the benefits, Surfshark is pretty cheap, standing at one of the lowest prices in the industry. And that's without considering you can get Surfshark VPN free of charge for 7 days on Android, iOS, and Mac. Or you could click the box in the corner and get Surfshark with a significant discount, the best I could find online. Hope you learned all you need to know about how to install Surfshark and use it, and let me know if you have any more questions. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon.